Hey everyone, welcome back to another Mining Chamber video. In today's video, we are going to be building an 8 RX 5700XT GPU mining rig. We got this GPU a while back and we had them sitting on the table for a while, so we're finally building this rig now. And just as our usual mining rig build videos, we are first going to talk about the parts, and then we are going to show a time lapse of the build, and then we will cover notes that are important to the build that we did. So if you have any questions, they're most likely going to be answered on that part. And then after that, we are going to set it up and start mining on it, and then discuss the profitability as well as how much watts and how much hash rates will this mining rig give us. So now first thing, let's go ahead and jump into the parts for this mining rig. So the first thing is the GPU, which we are using the Gigabyte RX 5700 XT model. We are going to be BIOS modding it following the tutorial that we made before, so we will get to that later on in the video. And then for the motherboard, we are using an ASUS B250 Mining Expert paired with an Intel Celeron G3900 and an 8GB RAM stick. And then as for storage, we are using a 120GB SSD, which we will be installing Windows 10 on. And this time we will try using a different mining software that's not Phoenix Miner, but instead we will be doing something different. And then after that, we have our power supplies, which we are using two RMX 850 watts PSUs. I really do like these power supplies. They come with a fair amount of VGA cables that you can power up a good amount of cards with. Although later on we do have difficulties trying to power up these 8 cards with these power supplies, so we will also cover that after the build time lapse. And then we also got splitters and risers from nerdgears.com. They are really kind enough to send us a box full of splitters and risers, and we are really appreciative of that. And I recommend you guys to check out nerdgears.com. They recently put out the RTX 3000 series on their website, as well as they completely remodeled their website with a new design, and then there's the new splitters on there as well. They have two different types of splitters. The new ones are the braided ones, which are really, really good quality splitters. So I highly recommend you to check them out if you're looking for splitters. Their prices are really fair, and they also have a really good amount of GPUs that you can buy. And thank you again, NerdGears, for sending us the box full of splitters and risers. And then now finally in this build, we are going to be using a VetaFrame, a GPU VetaFrame that we had a while ago. The frame does look a little bit worn out, but it's okay. And surprisingly, we won't be using any RGB fans that we usually do. So this time it will just be the GPUs without any extra fans. Now that we covered all the parts, as for the prices, you guys will be able to find all these prices in our website, miningchamber.com. There will be a full write-up on the bottom of the GPU overview article, where it shows all the builds that we did with this GPU. So we first made a 6 GPU build with the RX 5700 XT, and then this will be our second build with this GPU. So you guys can check it there and you'll find all the links and the prices, as well as the profitability and the break-even time. We will be getting back to that later on after we build this mining rig and test it out and see the hash rate that we get out of it. So now let's go ahead and run the time lapse for this build. Alright guys, I hope you have enjoyed the time lapse. Now let's talk about the important notes regarding this mining rig build. The first thing is, if you guys noticed in the time lapse, we were going to use one VGA cable for two GPUs, but then we ended up changing it to a CPU adapter instead, since we realized plugging two cards to one cable is not going to be a good idea. And then we asked around as well, and we got an advice to use a CPU to GPU adapter, which is basically just like your normal splitters, except that you will be plugging into it a CPU 8 pin, and then in return you get a dual 8 pin for a GPU. So we ended up using two of these to power two different cards, and then we had the other six cards running on the VGA cables from the power supplies. And since we have 8 risers, we used two regular splitters to power up two risers through one cable and one GPU. So like that, in total we had 4 cables that are powering the GPU and its riser, and then we had 2 cables that are powering a GPU and 2 risers as well. And then for our second note, we did BIOS mod all of these GPUs. We used the tutorial that we released a while ago to BIOS mod all the Gigabyte cards. But just remember, when you have a Gigabyte or a ROG Strix card, you will need to use a specific BIOS image that's unlocked, which will be pinned in the comment sections of our BIOS modding video. And we will also leave the link for that video in the descriptions below. And I want to say thank you, Crypto Peasant from Red Panda Mining Discord, for giving us that information to put on the comment section. After BIOS modding all the cards, we ended up getting a little bit extra mega hash. So now every card is working around 54 to 55 mega hash. And then later on, after we set up the operating system, we will jump into the temperatures and how we overclock the cards. So that will be it as of the side notes for now. If you have any questions or anything that we didn't cover on the side notes, please let us know in the comments below. Now let's go on and move on to setting up the operating system. So initially my plan was to run it on Windows 10 and use a different mining software, but it seems like it was a lot of troubles running 8 cards on Windows 10 and trying to get them to mine without crashing. So instead I ended up installing HiveOS on the SSD, and then I plugged that back into the rig. After getting HiveOS all set up and getting all the overclock set up, everything has been running smoothly for about 6 hours so far, and the rig has been working pretty well. There are some more room for optimizations for the overclocks. I can still reduce more power usage, but as of now I'm going to keep it that way until I have time to mess around with it a little bit. So usually the temperatures of the GPUs go above 90 degrees if I leave the fan speed below 60%. So I ended up keeping the fan speed at 80% at all times to keep the memory temperature below 90 degrees. With these cards, it's fine, you can keep it running at 95 degrees and below, but it's always better to keep them cooler. So I would recommend pumping your fan up if you do have really bad temperatures. And as for our overclocks, we are using a 1300 core, 770 undervolt, and as well as 850 on the memory voltage and 900 on the memory frequency. Contrary to Windows and HiveOS, for these cards you would need to put half the value that you would put in Windows. So in Windows you would do 1800, but here I did 900 instead. And other than that, everything has been running smoothly like I mentioned. And now let's go ahead and look at the power usage as well as the return on investment on this mining rig. So for power monitoring, we are using the smart plugs on the wall. So we have the two PSUs connected to two different smart plugs. The first PSU is drawing around 660 watts, and that is powering 4 different cards as well as the system. And then the second PSU is drawing around 650 watts, and it's powering just 4 cards. So now we can just round it up around 1300 watts, 1350. And like I mentioned, there are more optimizations that can be done to drop the watts lower. So now let's go ahead and go to the sheet that's on our website, and then we can look at the prices there as well as the expected time to break even. So we can go ahead and look here. The prices of the items that we use for this mining rig costed us around $3,223. So that is through the deals that we were able to get, as well as the free stuff that we were able to get as well. But if you would buy this off the shelf, you will get it around $4,376. We were pretty lucky on the GPUs. We got them for a really decent price on Newegg. We did buy it a while ago, and we were able to get it around $475 Canadian because they were all refurbished. So converting that to USD, it will come around $340. So if you do want to calculate this total with tax, just make sure you multiply your tax percentage with the total and then just add the difference. So now let's go ahead and take a look at the break-even and the performance of this rig. So if we slide here to the right, we will see here that we have the performance. So as for the performance, we are able to get 435 mega hash from this rig, and then the total wattage will be around 1300. So we've put these numbers in the whattomine.com calculator, and we were able to get these results. So for your monthly return, you will be making around $412 without electricity cost. And then for electricity cost, we're using 0.10 cents per kilowatt hour. So that would cost around $93.60 a month, which means our monthly profit after subtracting the electricity cost will be around $320. And just remember, all these numbers are based on December 5, 2020. So these numbers do change very frequently. And if you do want the updated results, if you watch this video 1 month from now or 3 months from now, you just need to click on the view updated returns, and then it will take you exactly to the calculator with all the values filled in. So now the next thing we can look at now is the return on investment. For the price that we were able to get it for, we are going to be able to break even in 10 months using the 0.10 cents per kilowatt hour electricity cost. And then if I don't have to pay any electricity cost, the break even will be around 8 months. And now if you look at, if you bought it brand new, you will probably break even in around 14 months if you have that electricity cost. And if you don't have to pay any electricity cost, it will be around 10 months and a half. So as of performance and return on investment, that will be it. And just a reminder, if you guys want to buy any of these parts, you will find all the links on the right side. We will also leave all these links in the descriptions below. So that will be it for this video. If you guys have any questions or feedback, please let us know in the comment sections below. And if you enjoyed it, please leave a thumbs up. And also don't forget, there will be a wallet on the screen that you can recover on Coinomi to get the money out of it as part of our giveaway. And then there will be one more wallet in the next video. We hope you guys have a wonderful day.